This morning, we exalt your name, oh God. We lift you up in the highest place, hallelujah. We give you the glory, the honor, and the praise that is due to your name this morning. Oh God Almighty, we come before you, hallelujah. Oh God, to lift up and to magnify your name this morning. Oh, we worship you, Holy Father, hallelujah. We glorify your name, Almighty God. Hallelujah. Oh, we honor you this morning, righteous Father. We exalt your name, King Jesus, for you alone is worthy to be praised. You alone is worthy to be lifted up and glorified. King of kings and Lord of lords, hallelujah. Our Redeemer, our Sustainer, hallelujah. Our Deliverer, glory to God. Our Healer, our Provider, our Protector, Waymaker, Miracle Worker, hallelujah. Promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that's who you are. You are a good, good Father. Hallelujah. And we are loved by you, Almighty God. And this morning we come, hallelujah, with our hearts filled with praise. Oh God, we enter into your gates with thanksgiving and into your courts with praise. Hallelujah. We are thankful unto you and we bless your name. Glory to God. For truly your mercy is everlasting and your truth endureth to all generations. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for assembling us together one more time. Hallelujah. Oh God Almighty, we give you glory, honor and praise. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We thank you for bringing us, oh God, to another milestone. Hallelujah. 15 years, oh God. Hallelujah. We couldn't have done it without you. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We thank you for your keeping care. We thank you for your tender mercies. Oh God Almighty, we thank you for your provision, Almighty God. Hallelujah. And your protection. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we commit ourselves into your hands one more time. We pray, oh God, that you will sanctify us again. We pray, Father, that you will consecrate us, hallelujah, to your service today, oh God, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus, as we present our bodies to you, a living sacrifice, hallelujah, holy and acceptable unto thee, which is our reasonable service. Help us, oh God, not to be conformed to this world, but to be transformed by the renewing of our minds. God Almighty, we look to you this morning as we commit today's service into your hands. We pray that you will lead by the power of the Holy Ghost. We pray that you will move in our midst, Almighty God, that you will have your own sweet way among us in the name of Jesus. We pray, oh God, that you will come and tabernacle with us today in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. God Almighty, we commit every aspect of the service in your hands. Oh God, let your anointing do the work today. Hallelujah. Let your anointing destroy every yoke this morning, undo every burden and set every captive free. Clear the atmosphere this morning, Almighty God. Shake everything that need to be shaken, and those things that cannot be shaken will remain. Hallelujah. We look to you this morning, O Holy Father. O God Almighty, we commit your people into your hands. The choir, the praise team, the musicians, hallelujah. Oh, glory to God, all the saints, Almighty God. We commit them into your hands this morning. We lift up our bishop, oh, glory to God, and our first lady before you. God Almighty, we pray that you will ever continue to bless them. Ever continue to lead and direct them, oh God. Keep your hands upon them that no evil cannot harm them. Remember the moderator this morning. Anoint her, God, hallelujah, and use her for your glory. In the name of Jesus, we pray this morning that you will mantle and undergird the speaker for today. God, truly there's a word in the house today. Help us to hear what the Spirit is saying to us, Almighty God. Oh, Holy Father, mantle and undergird your servant, hallelujah, and let your word go forth with power and with clarity. Have your way in our midst, we pray, Almighty God. Touch everybody this morning, every sick body, hallelujah. Every discouraged heart, encourage this morning. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. For there is hope for a look, hallelujah, at the crucified one. Have your way, we pray, oh God, as we wait upon you with great expectancy. We give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise, hallelujah. We tell you thanks, for we ask these and other mercies. In Jesus' holy and precious name, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Praise the wonderful name of Jesus, hallelujah. I greet the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, hallelujah, who is the head of our lives. Glory to God. I greet our honored bishop and assistant pastor. Praise God, hallelujah. Oh, praise the name of Jesus. All the ministers in their respectful places and all you wonderful saints, I greet you in no other name but in the matchless name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior and soon coming King. Praise the name of Jesus. It's good to be in church this morning. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. I don't take it for granted. Glory to God, because many would love to be here and are not here because of circumstances beyond their control. Glory to God. We are going to tune our voices and sing 360 from the redemption. I've found a friend in Jesus. He's everything to me.
Oh,
Jesus. Hallelujah. He's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul. Oh, glory to God. Thank you, praise team. Praise the Lord. We are going to turn our Bibles, glory to God, to Isaiah 14. Isaiah 14. We read from 1 to the end. Isaiah 14. Praise God. I'm going to ask that we all stand for the reading of God's holy word, and we are going to read together. I still hear leaves turning. It's after Daniel, before Joel. God, we begin. O Israel, return unto the Lord thy God, for thou hast fallen by thine iniquity. Take with you words that turn to the Lord. Say unto him, take away all iniquity, and receive us graciously. So will we render our calves our lips. Assyria shall not serve thee. We will not try. Neither will we say any more to the work of our hands, ye are our gods. For indeed the fatherless findeth mercy. I will heal their backsliding. I will love them freely, for mine anger is turned away from him. I will be as a dew unto Israel. He shall grow as a lily and cast forth her roots at Lebanon. His branches shall spread, and his beauty shall be as the olive tree, and his smell as Lebanon. They that dwell under his shadow shall return. They shall revive as the corn, and grow as the vine, and scent of shall be of Lebanon. Ephraim shall say, what have I to do anymore with idols? I have heard him and observed him. I am like a green fir tree. From me is thy fruit found. Who is wise, and he shall understand these things? Prudent, and he shall know them. For the ways of the Lord are right, and the just shall walk there, but the transgressors shall. Amen. Praise the Lord. The name of Jesus. This is the word of God. It is already blessed. We honor it by saying, glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Ghost. As it was in the beginning, it's now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Before we turn over to our moderator this morning, I'm going to ask the praise team to help me do this song. Glory to God. I saw the Lord. I am lifted up.
Yeah. God, because he's worthy to be praised. There ain't nobody like Jesus. Ain't nobody can do us like Jesus. I'm talking about Jehovah, my Lord. Oh, glory to God. I'm talking about Adonai, my master. I'm talking about Jehovah Jireh. I'm talking about Jehovah Mr. Day. I'm talking about Jehovah Shalom, our peace. Giving honor to God who is first in my life. I welcome the Holy Spirit in this place. Take it down slow. Don't stop. That's an awesome music. Giving honor to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I welcome our Bishop and our First Lady. Come on, give it up for our Bishop and our First Lady. We're celebrating 15 years deeper life. 15 awesome years. When you look back over your life, can you think where you was 15 years ago? Ain't God good? And with this song, they're going to take it back up. We're going to fellowship with one another. Bring it up now. Come on, everybody. Let's fellowship. Welcome somebody.
I saw the Lord.
Welcome somebody.
I saw the Lord. He was high and lifted up.
High.
And his train filled the temple. High and lifted up. And his train filled the temple. The angels cried.
Among us today, anyone visiting with us for the first time, can you please stand so we can identify you? Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. On behalf of our Bishop, Dr. Claude Hibbert, and our First Lady, Dr. Sonia Hibbert, we just want to take the time out to thank you for visiting with us today and for making Deeper Life your place of worship. As you celebrate with us, as we celebrate our 15th year, we hope that this may not be your last time here. So we pray that God bless you and you enjoy the service. Thank you for coming.
To all our visitors, welcome. You're in a good place this morning. And you could not be in a better place this morning. Especially in this day, this year. You know, this is Black History Month, right? And we all celebrating. We got 29 days this year, so y'all better clap on that one. 29. We're in a leap year. We know that in the movies they have Harriet. Anybody saw that? You see, she was a great woman. And she did a whole lot. The history says that she freed over 300 slaves. And she was a terrific Black woman. They call her the Black Moses because she ran the Underground Railroad. It wasn't the train that you take, the subway. It was because there was a network of people who came together to give aid to the slaves. But you know, I love to celebrate people. But there's this woman I'd like to celebrate because she's also a beautiful Black woman. Let me tell you, I heard she came from Jamaica. She and her husband here to do God's work. Yes, they had some hills to climb when they came. But today we're celebrating 15 years. And I want somebody to understand that we have our own history in Deeper Life World Outreach Ministry. I want somebody to know that we have our own Black woman. She may not be on the pages of history, but she's in Deeper Life history. Get up off your feet, somebody, as we celebrate this Black woman from Jamaica. She came to preach God's word, to tell somebody about Jesus. I'm talking about the Black woman I'm talking about. Is Reverend Dr. Sonia Hibbert. We have our own Black Moses in the house. I said we got our Black Moses in the house. This is the Black woman we're celebrating among the pages of history. We have Harriet, we have Sojourner Truth, we have Rosa Parks, and we have now Dr. Reverend Sonia Hibbert, one of the greatest teachers that I know. Come on, Deeper Life. We're celebrating 15 years. Isn't it ironic? We're celebrating in the month of Black History. How awesome is that? Give it up for the Black woman in the house. And for every Black woman, for every person in this place, I know this is Second Sunday, Women's Sunday. I honor all of you. I honor you. Because you are the strength of a man. I didn't say that because I understand behind every man there's a strong woman. Ain't God good? Ain't God good? So as we celebrate this month, 29 days, and that note I'm going to call the announcer to come. If the announcer would just come. Oh, I love this little one. She speaks like this in God's name.
Bless the Lord, everyone. Let me first give honor to my bishop and my first lady. To our guest speaker for this morning, I honor you, woman of God. To all the ministers and the officers, and to you wonderful saints of God, a pleasant morning to you all. The announcements for February 9th, 2020 are as follows. Happy 15th birthday, Deeper Life. We invite you to watch our telecast on the Manhattan Neighborhood Network, channel 1997, every Tuesday from 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. Tune in every Sunday morning from 5:30 a.m. to 10 a.m. on 99.3 FM and 88.9 FM, or on www.voptv.net, or on your phone at 832-225-5352 for our Deeper Life broadcast. In Grenada, our broadcast is available on 197.9 FM and 90.1 FM. We invite you to our Bible study every Sunday from 9:30 a.m. to 10:45 a.m. We have edifying classes where the rich, purified, and unchangeable Word of God is presented. All age groups from 1 to 100 years old are welcome. Please join us next Sunday and you will be blessed. There will be fasting service this Tuesday at 10 a.m. There will be Bible studies and prayer meeting this Tuesday night at 7:30 p.m. There will be youth meeting this Friday at 7:30 p.m. Each Saturday morning from 7 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. will be divine intercessory prayer. There will be youth choir rehearsal this Saturday at 3 p.m. For those interested in receiving their tax letters, please see Reverend Gail after church today. Celebrate with us in our 15th annual anniversary service as Deeper Life reaches 15 years of existence. Join us again tonight at 6:30 p.m. We convene under the general theme, Reflecting God's Glory. Invite a loved one, a neighbor, a friend, co-worker, or schoolmate to one of these services, which promises to be rich and enlightening with the preaching of the gospel. Full Gospel Church of God number 2 celebrates their annual prayer breakfast on Saturday, February 15, 2020 at 9 a.m. The cost is $25 for adults and $10 for children. The address is 25 Aberdeen Street in Brooklyn, New York. International Pentecostal City Mission invites us to their prayer breakfast on Saturday, February 15th, 2020 at 9 a.m. This will be held at 9202 Church Avenue in Brooklyn, New York. The cost is $25. Our trip to Sight and Sound Theaters is set for May 23rd, 2020 to see Esther. There are no more seats available, but in order to secure your seats, a down payment is required. Please see Deaconess Maskell and Deaconess Gordon for more ticket information. Here ends the reading of our announcements. Please bear them in mind and set your schedules accordingly. God bless you. Thought for the week. Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. Martin Luther King Jr. Romario Hill will celebrate his birthday on February 13th. Sister Jacqueline Campbell will celebrate her birthday on February 14th. And Sister Cynthia Sawyers will celebrate her birthday on February 15th. Happy birthday and God bless you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
From the Deeper Life family, I now hand over to our Reverend.
Thank you very much, my dear. Wasn't that a beautiful announcement? I love her voice. You know, she just made an awesome quote about Dr. King. Tell we're still in celebration.
I could tell you a whole lot about some people like Medgar Evers, Dr. King, but there's a black man in the house. I said there's a black man in the house that I'd like to acknowledge right now. I said I gave you the woman, I'm giving you the man. There's a black man in the house who also came to this country from Jamaica. And you know, yes, as I mentioned before, they had some hills to climb. They've had some sleepless nights. But I want everybody to get up on their feet and welcome and honor this black man of the house. I'm talking about none other than Bishop Dr. Claude Anthony Hibbert. This is the black man that God has given us. Our Moses. I thank God for this man. He's a man that we run to when we need a prayer every now and then. Every now and then we could call on this man. I'm talking about this awesome black man. Give it up for the black man in the house, our bishop, Dr. Claude Anthony Hibbert. And it's ironic we're celebrating 15 years, as I mentioned, on this day. What a celebration. 15 years. And I'd like to also welcome our guest speaker, Minister Blair. She's a dynamic woman. Dynamic woman, and as the choir gets ready to come, please choir, get ready, and after the choir we have babies to be blessed. So I'm asking the choir to come now, and then after the choir, we're going to bless some beautiful children. Ain't God good? Ain't God good? Ain't God good? Is he good? When I think of the good name of Jesus, and as the choir get ready, go on, brother.
Thank you. While the babies are coming, could we just sing that one, two time again? One more time. One more time. Time again, they are still coming. Scripture has been dedicated to this service in their honor. And that's found in Mark chapter 10, verses 13 through to 16. And it read like this. And they brought young children to him that he should touch them. And his disciples rebuked those that brought them. But when Jesus saw it, he was much displeased and said unto them, suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of God. Verily I say unto you, whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child, he shall not enter therein. And he took them up in his arms, put his hands upon them, and blessed them. I'm going to ask every person, if you can stand, please to stand. Point your hands down here, and those that is behind us on the choir, point your hands towards K.D. Grace Garcia and Mark Moison.
This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Before God and all mankind, we come to witness this day. The dedication of these two babies, Grace and young Mark. Oh, Almighty God, as we present these two little infants to you, we ask, Almighty God, that you continue to cover them from their head, oh, Almighty God, to their toes. We ask, Almighty God, that even their infancy, that, oh, Almighty God, that you will continue to smile on them. You will continue, Almighty God, to hush them in your presence. You will continue, Almighty God, to encircle them with your robe of comfort and love. We ask, Almighty God, that you will make provision, Almighty God, when there is no provision for them. We ask, Almighty God, as they begin to grow, Almighty God, begin to creep, begin to become aware of what this world is, Almighty God, that they too might come into enlightenment, Almighty God, of the things that you have prepared for them. We thank you, Almighty God, one more time for this day, for this present. We know, Almighty God, that they are an heritage, and the wombs that brought them, Almighty God, is already blessed. And so we come to dedicate them back now unto you, Almighty God. We thank you for the very breath, Almighty God, that they take. They, Almighty God, shall be trees planted by rivers of water, and their fruit, Almighty God, shall come forth in due season. We ask, Almighty God, as they begin to grow and become a part of society, Almighty God, that you prepare the way for them. You make it, Almighty God, that they will have good education. They will have good examples, Almighty God. They will have good people around them, Almighty God, to carry them to hold their hand. We ask, Almighty God, that even the parents, that you provide for them also, Almighty God, that they too will have to provide for these kids. They too will have godly influence in them and therefore have it on their kids, Almighty God. We ask, Almighty God, that these kids grow and become adults, that their contribution, Almighty God, to society might be as you would ask. Grow up a child in the way that he should grow, and when he's whole and when they're whole, they shall not depart from it. Almighty God, we come one more time in your presence, asking for your blessing, for your guidance, for your provision, for your comfort. And these two, little Mark, Almighty God, and little Grace, whatever we fail of asking, Almighty God, fail not to grant it unto us. These are the mercies we ask. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Father, here holding my hand, little Katie Grace, fearfully and wonderfully made in your image and in your likeness. I present her back to you even now, O God, and I declare her blessed in the name of the Father, blessed in the name of the Son, blessed in the name of the Holy Ghost. Little Katie Grace is blessed and given back to you in Jesus' name. Father, here, and I hold my hand, little Mark, fearfully and wonderfully made in your image and in your likeness. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we present to you, O God, little Mark, blessed in the name of the Father, blessed in the name of the Son, blessed in the name of the Holy Ghost. Little Mark is blessed and given back to you even now, in Jesus' name. It's amazing how these little infants are just so very aware at this early stage. I'm going to ask the parents to come forward. Amen. As I normally say, and I repeat for emphasis, is that nothing that has transpired up to this point is accidental. Before you both were formed in your mother's womb, before you both were even formed in your mother's womb, God knew this day. And little Mark is not an accident. God knew that at this particular time, at this particular season, you would have been at 837 Rogers Avenue, dedicating him and giving him back to him. It's not an accident. He knew that Katie Grace would have been here at this time and this season. And because it's not an accident, and because before you were even born, God knew of this day, it is so important that you view these two infants very special, because before you existed, they existed in the mind of God. And the fact of the matter is that secondly, you have to consider yourself so important that God could have created other persons with the DNAs that he needed to have brought these two infants into the world. But he chose you, chose you, chose you, chose you. That's God's choice. He could have made someone else and put the DNA that he placed in you in that individual. Could have done the same thing with you. Could have done the same thing with you. The same thing with you. But you are so special and so unique to the plan of God and what he has in store for these infants that he handpicked you as parents. Nobody else could have brought forth these two infants. It had to be you, 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 and you. Now, if God went through so much details to have handpicked the parents, it is therefore that nothing that these two infants will ever need that you can call to the God that gave you this job. He gave you this responsibility. And whatever crisis that hits you, remind him that before I existed, Mark existed in your mind. Before I existed, Katie Grace existed in your mind. This is your doing, so you've got to help me in this. And he has documented in the word that you should call up on him in the time of trouble. And he said, I'm going to hear you, I'm going to answer you, and I'm going to show you great and mighty things. Great and mighty things. Finally, what you both have to understand is that if you have never seen a miracle, every time you look at Katie Grace and Mark, you see a miracle. Let's just look at how it started and look what have evolved after 9 months. Look what has evolved. It's a miracle in itself. It's something that we could seek to work out principles. We can't define. Our child is so miraculously formed in someone's womb and just comes out. And look what happens after just a couple of months or where they are in their surrounding. It is as if they were here before. They have just grasped everything because of the wisdom of God. You're therefore saddled with a tremendous responsibility to guide and to protect and to provide for these two infants. But God is going to help you both, and God is going to provide for you both. With your heads bowed, your eyes closed, and all those who are accompanying these two precious infants, join hands with me at this time. Loving Father and God, we thank you. We thank you for the parents of Katie Grace. We thank you for the parents of little Mark. God, you chose them. You handpicked them. And now they are here. They didn't experience miscarriage. They didn't abort. They carried out your plan. Now I commit them into your care, O God. And I decree and declare that they shall never lack. They will always have gainful employment. Lord, whatever Katie Grace and Mark needs, God, you will provide. At times before they call to you, you will provide. I pray, O God Almighty, that they will maintain sound health. Because sick parents can't adequately care for children. So I decree and declare that these parents shall have sound health. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I decree and declare that they shall be blessed going out, blessed coming in, blessed in their uprising, and blessed in their downsetting. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I pray, O God Almighty, that Lord, whatever they put their hands to shall prosper. I decree and declare and release that their endeavors, their dreams, and their aspirations shall become a reality in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You declare, oh God, that I should speak those things which are not, although they be and they shall become. I don't care what is their financial situation. I command that they be prosperous. I command that the spirit of prosperity rest upon them even now. In the name of Jesus, I decree it, I declare it. Oh God Almighty, there shall be an upturn and an increase, oh God, in their financial situation. In the name of Jesus, I decree and declare favor. Favor, divine favor. Divine favor, divine favor, divine favor. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I decree and declare that you shall be like trees planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth your fruits in season. Your leaves shall not wither, and whatever you go to shall prosper. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Now, God, I pray for every person that is gathered here in support of Katie Grace and Mark. I pray that they too, oh God, will be blessed with influence, will be blessed, oh God, with financial stability, will be blessed with sound health, will be blessed with good intent, that everything that they, amen, they perceive and conceive, oh God, to speak, amen, to Katie Grace or to Mark, will be influential towards their development in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And whatever they desire, oh God, to bless them with, amen, as gifts, that God, you will open the windows of heaven and pour them out blessings, oh God, that they will be able to fulfill their heart's desire in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Katie Grace or Mark are not coincidences. They are divine gift, amen, to society, to the earth, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And they will be blessed, and the parents will be blessed, amen, and the grandparents will be blessed, and the godparents will be blessed, the nieces and the nephews and the friends and the well wishers. I decree and declare blessings upon their lives even now. Whom God bless, no man curse. Amen. And you said, I shall decree a thing and it shall be established. I decree blessings upon their life. Abundant blessings, abundant blessings, abundant blessings, abundant blessings, abundant blessings. I decree it, I declare it, and it is established. And whom God bless, no man curse. And God declared that in blessing I will bless you, in prospering I will prosper you. God, we give you glory, give you praise, give you honor. And we thank you for Katie Grace, and we thank you for Mark, and we thank you for the parents, and we thank you for all involved. And now, with God, we just lift our voices and give you thanks, oh God, for your goodness. We're thanking you in advance, oh God. We're thanking, we're putting a thanks on what you intend to do in their lives, oh God. To you be the glory, to you be the praise. We tell you thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. God bless you and congratulations. God bless you, sir, and congratulations. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. And the Robinson will direct you. They're going to be taking photographs.
God is good. Woo! And that prayer by Bishop. Awesome. Come on, somebody. It was so touching. To God be the glory. And on that note, we come to the part where we all could participate in our giving. I could put the text on the screen and read you from the book of Malachi. But I just want you to know, as you get your offering together, that the word of God said, bring your tithes into the storehouse. And there's something that God promised us when we do that. He said that he will open up what? The windows of heaven. But you see, we got to do something first. Somebody missed that. I said, we got to do something first. He said, bring ye all the tithes into the what? Storehouse. That there may be meat in my house. So if we give to him, he will give back to us. The old folks used to say, you can't beat God's giving, no matter how hard you try. So I'm going to ask everyone to stand as we get ready for our tithes and our offering. Because we serve an awesome God. If we give to him, he said he will give back to us. It's just a matter of obedience. Because we serve a God who will give us anything that we ask. He said, ask and it shall be what? Given unto you. What an awesome God we serve. And every time that I have the opportunity to do tithes and offering, I will always say these words. Give God what's right, not what's left. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father God, I want to thank you for this day. This is the day that you've made, and God, we rejoice and we are glad in it. Father God, we are gathered here together, oh God, to glorify your name. And God, we thank you for those two beautiful children that was dedicated back to you. And now, God, we're about to give you a gift. You said, bring ye all the tithes into the store. We're bringing it to you now, God. We're going to place it, oh God, before this altar. Father God, we thank you for the offering that we're about to receive in the mighty name of Jesus. God bless it for the upkeep of your kingdom here in earth. Oh God, I thank you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the blessed Holy Spirit. Amen. Praise team.
Blessings are flowing. I give my best.
stop flowing to me.
Bishop Dr. Claude Anthony Hibbert. Please welcome the choir.
Thank you. The Lord is good. He'll give you everything. He'll give you everything.
Please rise to your feet as we welcome our bishop, Dr. Claude Hibbert.
Standing, join hands with your neighbor. Loving Father and God, we thank you for this moment, for this occasion. We pray, O God Almighty, for every person that has experienced ailment at this time. We pray, O God, that your hand of healing and deliverance will just rest up on them even now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We decree and declare healing in this place. We pray for every person in the midst of us, O God, that will be experiencing the discomfort of any type of ailing. I pray even now, with hands joined together and hearts looking to you and minds, amen, are on one accord, God, you will descend in the midst of us and you will grant healing. We pray for our streaming audience, and whatever is your need at this time, we decree and declare that the hand of God will visit you right where you are and will bring you the deliverance that you need at this moment. We thank you, O God, that you continue to bless your people. We thank you for this vehicle. We thank you, God, for the provision that you have made. We thank you for Open Door. We pray, O God Almighty, that this vehicle will grant safe motoring. We pray, God, that it will be efficient. We pray that, God, you will protect it from irresponsible and reckless users of the road. We protect it, O God, from thieves in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. So we cover this vehicle under the blood. And we decree and declare, O God, we pray even now that you will release your anointing in this place. O God, that preaching will be easy. We pray that every heart that is not yet surrendered to you will be heavily convicted. O God, that at the conclusion of this service, O God, they would have decided to surrender their hearts and their lives to you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we thank you. We release, O God Almighty, every person in here under your care, every person that views by streaming under your care. We release everything under your divine control even now. Have your own sweet way even now, O God, we pray. And we look to you, O God, and we tell you thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. Remain on your feet for another 30 seconds. We thank God for the opportunity for protocol in observance of that. We thank God for all our ministers, amen, atop and below, amen. We thank God for every one of you. We thank God for all our officers, all the saints. And we thank God for, amen, all our visiting friends and loved ones. We thank you for those that are visiting for the very first time. And we trust that up to this point you are not disappointed that you came, but we pray for the remainder of this service that the hand of God and the Spirit of God and the Word of God will bring strong conviction and consolation to your hearts. And by the time we would have come to the close of today's worship experience, that you would have been at a different place in your mindset, and your expectations would have been raised to a different level, and you would know that God is concerned about every detail of your life. And even though you might feel abandoned at times, God has you on his radar, and it's only a matter of time before your heart's desire will be met. God bless you, and God keep you, and God preserve and watch over you. We have a tremendous woman of God in the company of us today. Amen. And we go way back. As a matter of fact, we go far back, to the point that when I just arrived there, amen, and God has just so been so instrumental in her life over those years, and I've just watched her just grow and just blossom and just evolve and just explode and just expand, and amen, and such wonderful things are transpiring in her life, and amen, it's just such an honor today to have her to share with us, amen, in this opening session of our anniversary service, amen. And she's in a privileged place. I would normally be preaching, but I am going to be blessed just by sitting down and just listen to her preach. Amen. Put your hands together and make welcome Minister Victoria Blair as she speaks the mind of God to us.
Put your hands together and salute and celebrate the Lord. Come on, somebody shout hallelujah. We can do better than that for 15 years. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody lift your hands and give God glory. Somebody bless him for through many dangers, toils, and snares we have already come. Somebody bless his name. Somebody give him a hallelujah. Somebody give him a thank you, Jesus. For hitherto have you helped us, have you brought us. Somebody give him praise. Somebody shabak him. Somebody give him glory. Somebody love him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Giving honor to God. Amen. Who allowed me to be here on this, our 15th anniversary celebration. Amen. If it had not been for the Lord, amen. I bring you greetings from Bethel Covenant Ministries and Reverend Blair and the rest of the brethren there. Greetings and love. Amen. I just want to take time out to greet my bishop, Bishop Hibbert. Amen. And my pastor, Reverend Hibbert. All the wonderful pastors and ministers on the pulpit and in the congregation, I greet you. To the wonderful choir, amen, the musicians, I greet you. To the wonderful saints in the congregation, the visiting friends, the children, accept Christian greetings, and God bless you. You may be seated. Amen. Thank God for Sister Sonia Wright, who is always, I can't get rid of her. Even when I said don't come, she's there. Put your hands together for her. She's faithful. I love her. Even last night, I rough her up. Ooh. And this morning, she was right there and she was smiling, not a frown. Give God glory. Give God glory. Amen. Because when you know that somebody has great things in them, you got to push them. Amen. Even when they don't see it. So God bless you today. Amen. If you pray for me and talk with me, we will be out of here soon. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. I just love the Lord. And I love the opportunity to stand for him. Amen. Praise God. I would love for you to turn with me in your Bibles to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 9. And I think I will just go from the 24th verse. Praise God. 1 Corinthians chapter 9. And then I'm going to run over to the book of Hebrews 12, 1 to 3. 1 Corinthians chapter 9, 24 to 25. It says, do you not know that those who run in a race run all? But one receives the prize. Run in such a way that you may obtain it. And everyone who competes for the prize is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a perishable crown, but we an imperishable crown. Amen. The book of Hebrews 12, 1 to 3 says, therefore, since we are encompassed with such great cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and sin. Can I say that again? Let us lay aside every weight and sin that so easily entangles us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us. Bow your heads. Loving Father and God, I thank you today for your word. Father God, I'm standing so that you, through the ignition of the Holy Spirit, can speak through me. I've made notes, but it's nothing without the anointing. We thank you today, God, for listening ears and for hearts that will be open to receive. Clear the air and the atmosphere. Anything, God, that will hinder the word. Hallelujah. We come against it right now in the name of Jesus. Let it have free course in the name of Jesus. We take authority over everything, God, because when we gather together, not only saved people, our saints are gathered. Hallelujah. So we give you glory today, God, for the work working effectively in all of us today. Hallelujah. We thank you and we bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, praise the name of Jesus. He's worthy to be praised. Amen. Psalm 145 says, I will extol you, my God, O King, and I will bless your name forever. Every day will I bless you, and I will praise your name forever and ever. Somebody give him a praise. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. And his greatness is unsearchable. One generation shall praise your works to another and shall declare your mighty acts. Let us praise him together. Somebody give him glory together in the house. Hallelujah. I want to use, you have a theme, but I just want to use a little sub-team today. Hallelujah. Stay in the race. If you don't stay in the race, you cannot reflect the glory of God. Amen. Stay in the race. And not only stay in the race, but you got to fight to win your race. Amen. Amen. I took the time to research what a race is. And it says it is a competition between runners. It is a competition between runners. Or it is an event where you run to achieve something, or to gain an object at the end of that. A set course that you got to complete. Amen. A set course. As believers, we are all in the race. Amen. I take time to look around and I realize that there are many, many believers who are getting discouraged in this race. The race is not finished yet because it's a race that you got to run until you hear well done. Amen. But a lot of people are becoming discouraged when we should be looking up. When we should be clinging and holding fast to the unchanging hands of God, we are looking to quit. But I want to tell all the quitters or those who are about to quit or who want to quit that you got to get back into the race. Because there is no prize to gain for running and stopping in the middle. Amen. Amen, somebody. And as I look at it, I said, but this is not so much of a sprint kind of race either. Because you can shoot out at the starting line and in the middle you just burst. You get tired. Amen. Amen. So I want to describe this race for those of us who have been in a race that it's a marathon. And when you know how to pace yourself and when you know how to take a break every now and again, hallelujah, you're going to make it. Tell somebody you're going to make it. You're going to make it. Hallelujah. A race you've got to run with a strategy. Amen. In this race, you got to run it by faith. Any good athlete, he knows it takes commitment and it takes discipline. Somebody say discipline. Discipline. Hallelujah, because that's where our problem is, the discipline. Amen. It takes discipline to maintain a winning record. And if we study the life of the true athlete, we will see many rise up early. They go to work out all day. They get the proper rest and conditioning. They eat the proper food because they have a goal in mind. Any athletes get up and eat French fries and soda every day, then you can tell him, don't start the race. Any believer who is in the race and does not take time to pray, to worship, to fast, to seek the Lord, I'm telling you, you're running a race, but you're not getting anywhere. You're on the treadmill and you're moving, but you're not going much further than just moving your body. But when you have the right conditioning, you're in it for the long haul. Endurance is your goal. Because you got to finish this race. Tell somebody, stay in the race. Stay in the race. They work out to get the best results possible and to ensure that he or she is given the best possible chance to win. What is the state of your conditioning? Amen. What is the state of your conditioning? So it is in the natural race. So it is in the spiritual. We must absorb the spiritual food. And I know you don't lack the food in this house. So if you take time to digest it, if you take time to meditate on it, you will grow and you will be able to run your race. In the book of Corinthians that we read, Paul says, do you not know that all who run in a race, they run? But one receives the prize. So run that you may obtain it. I know there are many of us in this house today that are running. But you cannot look on your neighbor's race. You got to run your own race if you want to obtain the prize. You can't look at how they're conditioning because their 5-pound weight. against obstacles. They are there to prevent us from completing our race. So we take these obstacles and we set them up as mountains in front of us. Nobody's preventing you, you know. You are setting up your own obstacles sometimes. Come on, somebody. And even so, the enemy will present obstacles. But when you're focused and you know that you want to win, you're going to shut your eyes and you're going to look to Jesus. You're going to look unto the hills from whence cometh your help. For you know that your help cometh from the Lord, who have made the heaven and the earth. Somebody give him praise. Somebody give him praise. The enemy's job is to throw obstacles. And he does not rest. He works overtime. But your job is to fight. As you run, you fight. Tell somebody to fight. As you run, you fight. You're not going to run as one just beating the hair. But you're going to run with a purpose. Hallelujah. I've been saved from a young girl. And the devil is not going to take me out of this race. So come persecution, come. I'm set to run my race. Come discouragement, come. I'm set to run my race. Come hardship, come. I'm set to run my race. Do we have anybody in the house that says I'm going to run to the end? You can't give up now. Church is a school, a place where you learn. Hallelujah. And anytime you don't pass the first test, don't think God is going to move you from that area. You're going to have to take it until you pass it. If you don't like the sister so much, God is going to use you right there until you pass right there. Come on, somebody give him a praise. So don't think you're going to escape where you are until you deal with it. Tell somebody, deal with it. Good God Almighty, we have too much things in church that is pulling us, that is tugging us, that is causing us to fall out of the race. Somebody need to get up and stand up and say, I'm standing for Jesus. He's soldiers of the cross. Somebody got to lift high. No loss. Challenges are a must. And they will derail us if we are not careful. Amen. But ensure that your mindset is in the right place. Come on, somebody. Ensure that your conditioning is on tar. Or it's on par. Or it's on top. Ensure that you condition yourself with the word of God. You condition yourself in prayer and in worship. Come on, somebody. If you're an athlete, if you're running in this race, when you get up in the morning, what is the first thing you reach for or the first thing you do? Do you reach for your Bible? Because everything that is in here will protect me for the day. Or do you reach for your phone to see who texts you while you were sleeping? Then I tell you that your day is going to be at a loss. But when you put Jesus first, he will put you first. Somebody give God praise in the house. Somebody give him glory. I got to condition my mind to win. Hallelujah. Philippians 2:5 says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Somebody give him glory. So we have to develop our actions. We have to develop our deeds and be humble and be obedient to the Father. Somebody give him praise. We got to have a relationship through the word. Daily time of focused personal communion with God. Can I say that again? Because we are so busy. We work 2-3 jobs. We work, and it's all right to work. But I'm a believer that God will provide. In all the years I'm working, I never work on a Sunday. Because I make it plain when I go on the job. Sunday, don't mess with it. Tuesday, don't mess with that either. Because I go to Bible study. Amen, somebody. So you got to know what your priority is. So you got to stay focused. What do we do? Do we kneel and pray? Do we read the word? Do we meditate? What do we do when we get up the first thing in the morning? Let that soak in for a minute. Because the phone is, and I say this every time I speak, the phone is the number one killer of the Christian's focus on God. I don't know what we used to do before these phones came in, but I know I used to survive. Amen. Amen. So if we come back to the place of discipline, God in himself, he will do the same keeping that he kept us way back when we didn't have the phones. Oh, I got to check on my children. The children are right. Because if you place them in the hands of God the first thing in the morning, don't worry. Glory to God. Am I talking to the church today? It's 15 years. So therefore, we should be moving forward. We should be buckling up to run this race even to the next 15 years. Somebody give God glory. Hallelujah. Somebody used to sing, I look down the road and I wonder how far I am from God. So I buckle up my shoes and I started to run. I'm running. Somebody need to run their way back to God today. No excuses, because if you're not in the race, that means hell will be your portion. Somebody give God praise. We don't like the word hell anymore. They say God is too good of a God. But let me tell you, it's either heaven or hell. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Set the course of your day by renewing your mind in order to overcome the enemy's onslaught. And rest assured, he's going to come after you. Amen, somebody. When they sang the song this morning, he allowed us to come together. That blessed my soul. Amen. One more time. Because every time I get up, I'm grateful because it's one more time. Can we be real? When Kobe Bryant got up 2 Sunday mornings ago and left his home, he didn't know it was the last time that he was going to go through the doors. So can we take retrospect? Because when we leave our home, we don't know if it's the last time we're going to leave. And can I just tell you at this point, when you're leaving home, leave good. When you're leaving home, leave in the right frame of mind. Leave with your children saying goodbye to you, or you saying goodbye to them. Elijah, he had a little problem because I talked to him about something. And I said, boy, I'm a Jamaican. You're a Yankee. And may I raise you like a Jamaican, mother. And the boy get up, ready for work. Walk through the door. So you know me that? I said, look here, sir. You don't leave your house like that. A one mother you have. And I don't care how much you vex, or you huffing or puffing, You say goodbye, mommy. Have a good day, mommy. All when the thing burning you down in your soul. Can I talk to the church? So if we practice at home. But you malice the child malice you, and you're getting up to pray and to shout hallelujah and talking about your blessed and highly favored. The devil is a liar. You can't go to heaven with a carnal mind, for the carnal mind will leave you behind. Somebody give God praise. We're in a race and we are set to win. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Spiritual discipline are those things found in scriptures that promote spiritual growth among the believers in Christ. 1 Timothy 4:7 says, discipline yourselves for the purpose of godliness. Godliness is still right. Amen. And can I tell you, it doesn't matter where you have been. As Bishop said, there's nothing that you've been through or where you are now that is a surprise to God. So the things you have been through were to build you. The things you have been through were to strengthen you, good or bad. Amen. Because we are going to go through some things. But when the day comes, when you break that yoke and you begin to walk in maturity, no devil can touch you. Come on, somebody give God praise. Somebody give him glory. In this race, we seek to live godly, no matter what others are doing around us. Every now and again, we do a spiritual check. Amen. Amen. Am I in or am I out? Is God pleased with my lifestyle? Somebody give him praise. So I told your little friend, Drea. I said, Drea, if you are going someplace and you can take God with you, then it means you can't go. And it means you shouldn't go. Mm-hmm. Sometimes the two of them kind of gang up on me, you know. But they don't know who they're dealing with. I will talk from here so to Georgia. And the two of them will say, Lord have mercy. We're through the road a long time. But I'm talking because I want it to get through. I'm not going to go to heaven and you end up in hell. We're talking about the race. So the parents who don't want to run the race so your children can follow, I'm sorry for you. It's anniversary time. It's anniversary time. Run your race. And let them see that you're running. Certain lifestyle. I said, look here. You all see me living like that? If I don't live so, that means you can't live like. Come on. Somebody give God praise. Somebody give God praise. Somebody give God praise. We gotta live godly no matter what others are doing around us. And I don't want to be weighed in the balance and found wanting. Glory to God. I don't want to come up short when God calls for me. Too many years, too many miles behind me. Too many trials are through. Too many tears for me to remember. Somebody said there is too much. Too much. Too much. Too much to gain. Hallelujah. Glory to God. In this race, we got to have longevity. As long as we are alive, we got to keep on running. My God. And the devil knows what's in you, so he wants you to quit. And so does God knows what is in you. You've been running for 20 years, 30 years, 50 years, 60 years. But you got to keep on going. Keep on going until he calls you home or the rapture takes place. But you got to keep on running. Touch somebody and say, run! Hallelujah. Trouble is a must. Amen. Persecution is a must. But I heard somebody said the utter the battle, the sweeter the victory. Come on, somebody give him praise in the house. Ah, we are commanding the devil to drop his weapon and flee. For when we stand in the name of the Lord, who can? So today I'm declaring that there are no quitters in this house. If you are thinking about quitting, no longer will you quit. Because half of a race will not do. Three quarters of the race will not do. You gotta run the full length of the course. No matter what, no matter what, Red Sea. I know sometimes it looks like, but it only looks like. Because Pharaoh knew what was in the children of Israel. But God also knew what was in them. God knows what's in you. God said you have a place that you need to get to. Pharaoh decided that he was not going to let them go. But I love God how he works. He doesn't have to show me what the end looks like. Just keep me safe in the eye of the storm, God. Just keep me safe in the cleft of the rock. I don't need to know what's beyond tomorrow, for he holds my tomorrow in his hand. Somebody give him praise. All you need to know is that you remain faithful. All you need to know is that you run your race. Run it with dignity. Run it with class. Don't push nobody out of the way. Just go around them a little bit. And if you see somebody fall along the way, it's time to pick up somebody. It's come, sister, come. I'm running. I'm running. And I see that you have stumbled. But I came back to get you. Do we have any believers in the house who is willing to pick somebody up and run with them to the finish line? Are we talking about the church today? The only time you look down on a man is when you want to pick him up. I remember 25 years ago in the Olympics, Derek Redmond. He was running, conditioned himself for a good amount of 8 years. Prepare himself, kept himself well maintained, felt race ready. Anybody remember? Are you too young to remember? My God. Woo! But the brother looked like he was going to win the race. But somewhere in the middle of the race, he pulled up. He pulled up. Anybody remember? Yeah. And there were some who began to clap. Maybe they were saying, good, you fall out. So my runner that I have the bet on will win. Can I tell you that sometimes who you place the bet on is not the one God chooses? Come on, somebody give God a praise in the house. So you may pass them along the way. But don't you know there is somebody to come back and help them? So the boy's father, who was standing in the stand, saw the predicament, saw the obstacles, saw that the enemy came to kill and to steal and to destroy. Am I talking to the church? The father jumped over some hurdles. The father, the security, was trying to steal. come up against you one way, but they shall flee several ways. One shall chase a thousand, but two will put 10,000 to flight. So daddy, come. Can I talk you about the God that we serve? He will not leave you. He will not forsake you. Even though you are in pain, daddy sees. Daddy knows. Daddy has the remedy. Somebody give him glory in the house. Daddy came out of the stands. Hold his son by under the arm. And he said, you came. You conditioned yourself for years. I see that you need a little help, son. So I'm going to pick you up. And I'm going to get you across. He hopped all the way. He hopped all the way across the finish line. But daddy was there to help him. Can I tell you that when you get a little injury, church, injury is not easy. So when we get a little injury and we begin to limp, and those who you think should pick you up pass you and say, you can't stay here. I know you weren't going anywhere. But the determination that you have in you and the daddy that you know that you have, daddy will come alongside you. For he said, surely goodness and mercy, surely on my left, goodness on my right, the grace of God behind me. He said, I will follow you all the days of your life. Somebody give him glory, because you're still living, and while you're living, you gotta run. Tell somebody, run. As a matter of fact, turn to three people, even those you didn't talk to for a while, because in this race, no malice keeper, no malice keeper can complete it. Hallelujah. I don't know. I'm just saying. Those you didn't shake their hands for a minute, turn around. You need to find somebody and say, we are in this thing together. And we are not going to fall along the way. Good God Almighty, the Lord is my very present help in the time of trouble. Ah, God Almighty, did you do it? Did you shake somebody's hand? Did you move from your seat? Did you greet somebody that you didn't talk to for a while? It's anniversary time. Reflecting the glory of God. Good God Almighty, you gotta reflect Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. You gotta reflect Jesus. Hallelujah. Paul said in 2 Corinthians, he said, we are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Somebody give God glory. Somebody take a minute to shout hallelujah. Ain't no giving up. Somebody give him praise. Somebody give him glory in the house. Break the atmosphere. Hallelujah. And encourage somebody to run. All he was saying, we are surrounded and battered by trouble, but we are not demoralized. God is not going to allow it. Amen, somebody. At times we are not sure what to do, but we know that God knows what to do. We have been spiritually terrorized, but God has not left our side. Somebody give him praise. You may be thrown down, but you have not been broken. And if you're not broken, God can still, he can still cause you to finish your race. Stay in the race. Run the race. It's not yet over. And those of you who gave up because of what somebody did, it's time to get back in the race. You can't stand before God and say, Brother John caused me to slow up or to stop my race. He's going to say, you did run well, but who hindered you? Who are you going to let hinder you from reaching your goal? Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. God Almighty, we serve a God that is awesome and He's mighty. We can say like the Apostle Paul, I have fought a good fight. But you can only say that when you have fought a good fight. Even though you got knocked down in a few rounds, but you got up, it's a good fight. Not every champion wins the boxing match without getting knocked down. He was knocked down, but he was not knocked out. And as long as you have life, you have hope. Somebody give God praise. He said, I fought a good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award me on that day. And he said, I'm not to me only. Do you want your crown? Do you want your crown? Do you want your crown? Then you gotta fight. You gotta run. You gotta run so that you may win. Come on, somebody, give God a praise. I have finished locked up in prison for preaching the word. Some of us have never been through half as much as Paul or some of those apostles, boiled in oil, hanged on a cross, beaten, beheaded, and they never lost faith. So we have those clouds of witnesses. Amen. If they made it, you can make it. Nudge your neighbor and say, you can make it. Because we are all in this together. Hallelujah, somebody. If they made it, you can make it. Somebody give God a praise. I'm coming down. He said, I've fought a good fight. I've been beaten 3 times. And you always hear me say these because I'm trying to get across to us that they went through so much for us today so that we could have this word to encourage ourselves. 3 times was I beaten with rods. Once I was pelted with stones. 3 times shipwreck. I spent a night and a day in the open sea. If not for God, I would have been eaten by sharks and sea creatures, imprisoned for preaching the gospel. He was running a race. In spite of it, he stayed focused because he was in it to win. And he said, neither was I afraid to die, for I don't count my life dear to me. For to me to live is Christ, and to die is gain. I consider my life worth nothing to me if only I may finish the race. What is your pledge today on this 15th anniversary? Are you going to keep running and help somebody along the way? Glory to God. I got to complete the task that God has given me or He has set before me. What are you doing? Are you making a difference? Did you come to make something happen? Or to watch what is happening? Did you come to make a difference? when we leave here today, we want to be saying, God, I was on the verge of quitting, but I thank you for reminding me, hallelujah, that if I don't finish the race, I don't have a crown to win. He said, I've finished the race. And I'm glad that Jesus, he knows, he's touched with the feelings of our infirmities. And he's sitting at the right hand. And he's cheering you on. Storm cloud may rise. And stormy winds may blow. But run on my child, run on. I'm right here waiting on you, hallelujah. No matter what, you're expected to win. Come on, somebody, give God praise in the house. You may have been disappointed at how life treated you, but he's saying, run on, because I'm right here and I'm waiting on you. For the joy that was set before him, he endured the cross. Keep your eyes. Can I say, keep your eyes on the chief leader? And I'm not talking about bishop. God places bishop here to lead. But above bishop is a chief leader. Come on, somebody. So keep your eyes on the chief leader. Glory to God. What you start out with, make up your mind that you're going to finish. He said, I didn't bring you this far. We sing some songs and sometimes we should stop singing them. I don't feel no ways tired. I've come too far from where I started from. Nobody told me that the road was gonna be easy, but I don't believe. But when you get in the middle of your obstacles, you're ready to quit. If you sing the song, believe what you're singing. If you read the word, believe what you're reading. Come on, somebody, give him praise. Keep your eyes on the chief leader. Glory to God. We may have lost some things, but God is expecting us to win. We have been through hell and back, but God is expecting you to win. No retreat. No surrender. We are going to fight. But we are not fighting as one with no purpose. We are not beating the air. When every time you go through something and you take a punch, connect. Amen. If we live ipshotted as Christians and you take a punch and nothing is connecting, the devil is laughing at you. All he's saying is, what are you trying to do? I got your number. But when you know the enemy has nothing on you and you are going through, say, devil, the Lord is my shepherd. You want to jab the devil? Somebody need to fight. Somebody need to give him a left hook and a right hook and an uppercut and say, the Lord is on my side. He's my son and my shield. He gives grace and he gives glory. Somebody throw a punch and tell the devil that you're in it to win it. We're too passive as Christians. And we are too comfortable. Somebody said the other day, he's a musician, and he said, the church just want them to play and just hype up everybody Sunday morning before the preacher comes. And I said, my God, what have we become? But when you know God is in you, good God Almighty, and you wake up Sunday morning, it didn't just start Sunday morning. Because right throughout the week, you got to condition yourself. Glory to God. And you begin to walk hand in hand along the way. Hand in hand. You're going to walk with Jesus and you will not stray. When Sunday morning come and you come through the doors, you don't come for Bishop to pump you up because you came with a praise. You don't come for the praise team to pump you up. You're going to lift your hands in the sanctuary and you're going to bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Lord, I bless your holy name. I don't need to crank you up because you've got a praise on the inside. Somebody give him praise. Somebody give him glory. Run your race with patience. Run your race with discipline. Run your race with integrity. Can I say that again? Run your race with integrity. Glory. You had me bound for a very long time. I'm going to church today. You backed me up long enough. I looked to my left and it was mountain. I looked to my right and it was mountain. When I looked before me, I saw nothing but the Red Sea. When I looked behind me, I saw Pharaoh and his army. And they are riding hard. And we are on foot. Oh, God Almighty. But that is the time when you stay focused. God said, Moses, now they are complaining. And that is our problem. We complain too much. Use the word. Come on, somebody, lift your Bible in the sanctuary if you came with one. Lift it up, lift it up. Use the word. God said, Moses, what is that that you have in your hand? And I'm going to ask you deeper life. What is it? Some of you didn't even raise the Bible yet. Lift it up. What is it that you have in your hand? Open it up from the front to the back. Every now and again I go down to pray. I open it up. And I say, God, I hear the sound of battle in the land. This is Jeremiah right here. And I say, and I hear of great destruction. But I know you are my refuge and my fortress. And in you will I trust. And every now and again, I turn the page a little more. And I said, the king of Babylon, he heard a report about me. Oh, God Almighty. And he's gathering his army because I'm preaching the word. Jeremiah said, God, what are you going to do about it? But can I go back to the children of Israel? God said, Moses, what is that you have in your hand? He said, it's only a rod. God said, if you just believe what is in that rod, you would use it. Tell somebody, use it. Use it to run your race. Use the Bible and its word to run your race. Somebody give God glory. Moses threw it down. Red Sea, open up. There is no Red Sea that God can bring you through. There is no obstacle that he cannot bring you over. I don't care who is coming behind me. I don't care how hard they are riding. Woo! He said, run, run, because the thing you're facing is just footman situation. So we just enlarge our business sometimes. We just use it as a stumbling block in our way sometimes. But say, move, mountain, move. If you move it, God can deliver. God said, Lord of mercy, I'm not straying. God said, Jesus said, show me the place where you lay. Jesus, they said, Jesus, by now, you stink. I know you have some stinking mess. Good God Almighty, all of us have them. None of us exempt. As long as we live in this world, we have some stinking problems. Jesus said, but I didn't ask you that. Show me where you left off praising me. Show me where you left off loving your brother or your sister. Show me the place where you became discouraged. Show me the place where you got so discouraged that you don't want to come to church. Show me. He said, if you show me, and he said, roll away. I'm asking you today, roll away the stone that is hindering you from running your race. Jesus said, Jesus have a sense of humor. He said, roll it away. So I'm here to tell you, if you roll it, God can deliver you. God couldn't deliver Lazarus until it was rolled. If you roll it, God can deliver. Come on, so anybody need deliverance today? Because I need people who didn't come to remain cute. I came with some makeup on. But it's all right if at the end of the day there's no makeup. Yeah, it's all right if at the end of the day my wig comes off, even though I'm not wearing one. So somebody need to get up on your feet and roll it away. Come on, somebody just roll. Because we have some stinking problem. Roll it away. I want to run my race, God. But Lazarus is in my way. Lazarus need to come forth. The stone is in my way. So I'm rolling it away today. No more am I going to let the enemy stop me. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Daddy disowned you. Roll it away. Mommy disowned you. Trouble in the home. He's cheering us on. When the children of Israel went through, just remain standing. I'm done. God will let you watch your enemies drown. And I don't care what that enemy, it's not necessarily a person. The things that entangles you, the heavy weight and the sin that so easily entangles you from preventing you from running your race. But we're gonna press past all of that. We are pressing because we are heading somewhere. We're going to press past the oppression, the confusion, the depression. Come on, somebody. We're almost at the end of the race. Believe it or not, look around us and you will see what is happening. We are living in the end time. So I want to encourage you today, as I bid you adieu, stay in the race. Hold to God's unchanging hand. When you get perplexed, get back in the word. God, a chapter a day will keep the devil. So can you imagine if you read a chapter every day of the week? Woo! I don't know how many of you have those little daily word on your phone. It will pop up, show you the scripture for the day. How many of us read them? Don't show your hands. We will crawl past it to go and see what is happening on Facebook. But when you make that spiritual deposit, you're able to withdraw. Peter says, and I close with this, be sober, be watchful, because your adversary, the devil, walks around like a roaring lion, seeking whom. Come on, talk to me now. The word says resist him. Resist him firmly in faith, and he will. Knowing that the same afflictions are experienced by your brotherhood throughout the world. What you are going through is nothing new to the other believers. But today we are making it up in our minds that we're not quitting. We're not giving up in this race. For those who are not saved today, the altar is open. Because you need to get in the race. Those who stopped in midway, you need to come. To say, Lord, if I don't finish my race, I told you already, take Kobe as an example. The brother left to come back home. It may not be a helicopter. You may be on the train. You may be on the sidewalk. You may be in your very home. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. You're in the race and you cannot quit. He said, after you have suffered a while, the God of all grace, who has called us to his eternal glory through Christ Jesus, he will restore you, he will support you, and he will strengthen and establish you. Lift your hands in the house. To him be glory and power and dominion. I want to encourage you today. Stay in the race. Fight the good fight of faith. And lay hold. Take a hold of your eternal life. Hallelujah, somebody. Somebody lift your hands now and give him praise in the house. As I hand over to Bishop, somebody give him praise in the house. Come on, somebody give him glory. You've made up your mind to stay. Somebody give him praise.
Let us all stand. Every one of us here is in a race. I'm going to do two things quickly. I have 3 minutes to do that. I'm going to ask all those who came with little baby Mark to meet me down here, and all those who came in support of Katie Grace, meet me down here. Every person who came with little baby Mark as a support base, meet me down here. And all those who came with Katie Grace, meet me down here. While the preacher preached, something that struck me strongly, that we all didn't assemble coincidentally, but God had us all here for a particular purpose and a reason. Everybody, just come right down to the altar. Don't stand in the middle aisles or anything. Everybody, just come as close as you possibly can. And turn to me. When you come, turn to me. Come, turn to me. And I want you to join hands with someone. I want to pray a prayer of coverage over your lives. Because when we leave here, we all have plans. We all have a destination in mind. But really and truly, we really don't know, in all honesty, where we are going to end up. We have a plan. We are intent on going someplace. But the reality of it is that we really don't know what the next minute or 2 or 3 minutes holds. And God would bring you here today to remind you that you are in life's race. You're in life's race. And you have to remember two things. We're going to pray, but remember two things. That one, Jesus said that the devil's plan is to steal, to kill, and to destroy. That doesn't change. I'm not concerned about your age. That don't change. He has not caught you in 30 years. He can catch you in 30 years and one day. He has not caught you in 50 years. He could catch you on 50 years and one day. His plan remained the same. He is on an agenda to steal, to kill, to destroy. And then Jesus gave you an alternative. He said, but I am come that you might have life, and that you might have life more abundantly. Heads bowed and eyes closed. Loving Father and God, we thank you. We thank you for Katie Grace, and we thank you for little baby Mark. But we thank you more than anything else, God, for all these persons who came out in solidarity, in concern, in appreciation for the preciousness, sacredness of the life of Katie Grace and baby Mark. And they came out to personally be a part of their dedication. But now, God, as they stand at this altar, stand in your presence, I pray, O God Almighty, that although that was their primary objective as they awoke this morning, to be at this church, to be one of the participators in the dedication service of Katie Grace or little Mark. But your plan is that you would be able to communicate to them. It was your plan, O God, that you would have them here, that you can speak over their lives, you can cover them, you can protect them. And even after they leave to fulfill their afternoon's obligation, you want them to remember that Satan's plan has not changed. But God, you want to cover them. You want to protect them. You want to set a hedge around their lives. So, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, set edges around each and every person here at this altar. There might have been some that had to slip out because they have other pressing obligations. I pray, O God, that as they journey to their respective destinations to fulfill their obligations, that even now, O God, your protective care will surround them. God, they would arrive at their destination safe, and during the participation of whatever their activities for this afternoon, that God, you will be with them. That's my request of you this evening, that you'll be with them, O God. And you will protect them and you will watch over them. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I pray, O God Almighty, that during their afternoon's activity, Holy Spirit, you will not cease from reminding them that you're in a life's race. And no race lasts forever. How prepared are you to cross the finishing line? What state of mind will you cross it in? What position in life will you pass it in? Holy Spirit of God, I pray even now that you will begin to communicate to their hearts and to their spirits. And Lord, you will remind them of how good you have been to them. There are persons at this altar that has never been seriously ill, and they have been on this earth for decades. They wake up each morning they might remember you, but they are not as convinced that had it not been you that are on their side, then while they slept, the enemy would have taken them away and put them into eternity. But they went to bed and they woke up in the morning to engage in their personal livelihood, to meet their earthly obligations, to fulfill the requirements of their respective jobs. I pray even now, O God, that during the course of these next 5 or 6 hours, you will not cease to remind them how good you have been to them. You have provided them homes, you have provided them cars, you have provided them jobs, you have provided them health. You have nourished their bodies. You have equipped them with good education. You have equipped them with careers. You have done everything earthly up to this point that they are needful of. And now you are asking them to just simply identify how good you have been in their lives. I pray, O God, that while they actively and joyfully participate in the activities that they have in mind this evening, that they will every now and again reflect that God has been good to me. They will reflect that surely goodness and mercy is with me. They will reflect that if it had not been God, then the enemy would have had his way. When we reflect on schoolmates, on relatives, on friends, on neighbors, when we make a contrast of our lives in comparison to their lives, you cannot honestly say that God has not been amazingly good to you. Keep them in remembrance, O God, of these things. And as they depart from here, I pray you will go with every one of them. I pray you will watch over them. I pray you will protect them. I pray you will continually provide for them. But Lord, I pray that you will continuously convict them concerning your goodness in their lives. Father, in the hands I commit each and every one of these loved ones. I thank you, God, for brought them here today. And I thank you for the word of God that you shared with them. They are still engaged in the race. They are still running. But God, I want them to take careful note of how they are running. Help them to take note of how they are running, where they are strategically placed, how equipped they are to finish this race and to finish it successfully. In the hands I commit them, even our God. Have your own way in their lives. Father, I thank you for answered prayer. And I thank you more than ever, less, God, for mercy granted to all these precious loved ones. May the love of God, may the peace of God, may the blessings of God forever overshadow your lives. And as you go forth, you will go forth with the peace of God that passeth all understanding. Keep them in acknowledgement of your goodness in their lives, O God. And to you we ask all these mercies and we tell you thanks. In Jesus' name. Right where you are, just raise your right hand. I'm going to dismiss you officially. Now may the saving grace of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the full fellowship of the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, rest, remain, and abide with us all, both now and forevermore. And the church declares, amen. God bless you. Have a wonderful evening and a safe evening in whatever your evening's activities. Amen. Please give me.